Free clinic is held in the Philippines to celebrate Zigi's 25th anniversary in the country. Zigi holds first certification ceremony for Overseas Volunteers of the Year in Hualien, Taiwan. I'm Sean Scanlon. This is Dai Headlines. It's the 25th anniversary of Zigi Philippines chapter. To celebrate, a free clinic was held in Ormoc City.
This is the first time Zigi Tima members held a large-scale free clinic in Ormoc City. Volunteers arrived at the Congo Central School 3 days in advance to complete the setting up.
We are very much fortunate for your presence. 3 days medical mission, because not all of us are good enough. We have enough money to treat the different sickness that we have. So thank you for your presence for these medical missions.
The Zigi Youth Band performed before the opening of the three-day free clinic. Even though the clinic hasn't opened, local residents formed a long line eager for treatment.
Our team of members traveled from Manila to Ormoc. At noon, we already saw many patients were waiting in the line for the treatment, so we decided to start early for surgery, especially the eye clinic division. Our doctors want to help all of them and wish to extend one more day for those optometry patients.
During the free clinic this year, the eye clinic was held in a hospital in Ormoc City. The rest of the departments were held in the Congo Central School.
Thank you, Zigi, for holding the free clinic in Ormoc so that I got a chance to remove my tumor.
The patient has a mass, has been there for quite some time, so now that he learned there's a Chuchi mission operating for free, so he was happy to come, and we're very happy also to accommodate him and operate the cyst, which without any problem.
The dental clinic was the most crowded clinic among other departments. Besides providing tooth extraction services, dental cleaning and filling, they also helped with root canal treatment.
We found out that some of the anterior teeth are damaged, so we explained to them the importance of teeth, and we told them that we can still save it by doing root canal, and by doing root canal, we clean the inside of the tooth, and then after that, we will transfer them for restoration to have a good set of teeth.
This is the six-year friendship between Zigi and Ormoc City after Typhoon Haiyan disaster in 2013. Zigi's love and care continues to care for those in Ormoc City.
Zigi Thailand Chapter CEO Lin Chunling received the Excellent Volunteer Award from the Thai government. She dedicated this honor to all volunteers doing good deeds. She was once a business leader but became a full-time volunteer in 2002.
We thought that it was a river when we first came here. However, the local residents said it was not. It was a farmland before. We're very happy to see that so many people are benefited from the wells. The flood has caused everyone to suffer, but we all know that after suffering, blessing is coming.
Lin Shunlin took part in many Zigi activities to spread her love to the affected people.
In Zigi's charity affairs, the New Shoes Scholarship Award is expected to relieve parents' burden.
She has seen many sufferings after joining Zigi and learned to count her own blessings.
Before, she was very
I used to be a very picky person. I wanted everything to be perfect. I would dress up myself. Everything I used was from the good brands. But I have changed in every aspect after I joined Siji for many years. I'm also very grateful to be on the right path now. I think my present life is more meaningful.
She has been joining Qiji for 17 years already. Lin Shenlin has received the Excellence Volunteer Award from Thai government. She said that this is the honor of all volunteers since it is the common achievement for them to spread love in Thailand.
This year's Filial Piety Award was given to 13-year-old Li Mengzhan. His father had surgery which left him paralyzed on the left side. Ever since he was in the sixth grade, he has been helping his father do rehabilitation.
Sitting on a wheelchair, Li Cainan is filled with delight to go on stage with his son, who is his best support after a surgery.
Because our family has encountered the problems, I need him to help me. He was only in the sixth grade, but he does it without any complaints.
The father had a surgery, causing his left side to not have any strength, and his son must care for him.
Li Mengzhan showed us the burden of helping his father with rehabilitation and his daily routines.
Dad brought me to this world and raised me, so I must reciprocate his love.
My heart goes to him because at such a young age he is able to do it. Even I couldn't do it when I was about his age, but he can. This is why I'm very grateful.
Siji volunteers helped solve the financial problem of this family and allowed Li Mengzhan to take a break. His only wish is his father recovers as quickly as possible.
In our next report, we'll meet an anemia patient who was given a second chance at life. Zhang Guozhen was diagnosed with this 30 years ago, and his condition deteriorated as his only hope was a stem cell transplant.
I've wanted to say I must come out alive.
Looking at the pictures, Zhang Guozhen values his family. More than 30 years ago, he was diagnosed of aplastic anemia and had to take medications to control his conditions. 7 years ago, his health deteriorated, and the doctor said unless he undergoes a bone marrow transplant, he only has a half a year left to live.
When the doctor announced I have fallen ill, I was really afraid. I trust the doctor, and the doctor encouraged me. He said, since we allow you to go into the operation room, we will make sure you'll walk out of there.
Fortunately, Zhang was given a second chance at life, and it only took 8 months since he applied for a transplant until he underwent the surgery. Despite the good news, his daughter was diagnosed with a brain tumor, so the family plummeted into darkness again.
I was prepared for it. When my daughter fell ill, we took care of her from the beginning till the end. There was no miracle cure for her brain tumor.
I didn't know what to do, as there were two serious ill patients at home. Back then, I was really tired. Even till now, I have not walked out of the shadows. I've lost my daughter.
Although he has not recovered from the pain of losing his daughter, Zhang Guozhen knows that he must stay strong for himself and for his daughter. He has been looking forward to this day.
When I know that the person I helped is very healthy now, I feel really happy. Seeing him like this, I think it is all worthwhile.
My husband's stem cell saved a family. Seeing his family like this, I feel very happy. I think my husband is really amazing.
Li Zhiheng's wife feels proud of her husband because his kind act has saved the family.
Because back then, my father was ill and so was my younger sister. Without his help, we might have lost two family members. Therefore, we are very grateful to him. Thank you.
Without the help of the stem cell donor, Zhang could not start a new chapter of his life. Now Zhang will live his life to its fullest.
Zhiji's first certification ceremony for overseas volunteers in 2019 was recently held. Master Zheng Yan officially attached commissioner badges, marking the beginning of their responsibilities. In the ceremony, participants also prayed for a world free of disasters.
Holding their badges in hand, these volunteers are being certified by Dharma Master Zheng Yan. This symbolizes that they shoulder more responsibilities and uphold the wishes of the Buddha.
For the past 2 years, when I watched the Master's teaching on the TV program Life Wisdom, I could feel how the Master has been worried about the people in suffering for more than 50 years. She is especially concerned about the wisdom life of her disciples. I feel deeply touched. I've decided to become a good disciple of the Master. From today, I will quit my smoking habit. I will start a new chapter of my life, so the Master does not have to worry about me.
729 people from 13 countries have been certified. Zhiji's footprints have been left in different parts of the world. Everyone vows to follow the Master and help the less fortunate people.
Okay, sekarang saya sudah dilantik. Ketika saya sudah dilantik, saya bertekad.
After being certified today, I will dedicate myself to charity work, because I cannot bear to see the less fortunate people suffer. In addition, I will dedicate myself to recycling and promote environmental protection.
Filled with Dharma joy, the certified volunteers vow to walk the Bodhisattva path. This certification ceremony marks the beginning of their new responsibilities.
物质富有，心灵的是贫瘠的，需要传法。我们要把它引导进了佛法的菩萨道，让人人丰富人生。这就是心灵导向。我们更要导向如佛门来，要发挥
Lighting up the heart lamps, other participants pray for a world free of disasters. They also vow to go amongst the public to alleviate people's suffering and pass on Zhiji's principles.
729 Zhiji volunteers from 13 countries gathered at the Jingsa abode and shared their experience after joining Zhiji. They also vowed to the Master that they would walk the Bodhisattva path.
Zhiji's newly certified volunteers from 13 countries gathered in front of Master Zheng Yan to share with everyone how they have been transformed.
Through learning from doing Zhiji work and realizing from learning, I have transformed. Now I feel doing Zhiji work can bring me so much happiness, not worries.
She was once very unclear about her goal, but now her goal is clear.
My husband used to laugh that I was a fake Zhiji volunteer because I would go with certified volunteers, but I didn't have the Zhiji logo on me. After I was certified today, I finally realized I have a master and I know my goal.
He once lived on the street, but now he is a certified volunteer. He will transform the help he received to move forward.
I vow I won't waste any second of my life. I'll do Zhiji work steadfastly and be Master's good disciple.
The Master expects that her disciples will walk the Bodhisattva path after making vows, and their goals will remain firm.
From
one to many, these newly certified volunteers make vow and hope the seed of goodness will take root in every part of the world and grow strong.
In Malaysia, a 69-year-old has been a heavy smoker and alcoholic for more than half a century. After he became a recycling volunteer in 2014, he quit his bad habits. He recently traveled to Taiwan to be certified as a Zhiji volunteer.
I have been smoking for more than 40 years. I used to start feel like smoking when I started my rubber tapping job at 4 in the morning.
Within 2 hours of rubber tapping every day, Liu Renshen could finish a package of cigarettes.
He smells like hell, but even when I warned him, he still smoked.
Not only a heavy smoker, Liu Renshen often have drinks with his friends.
I used to have a lot of drinks with my friends after work and had fights with my wife after someone drove me home.
Since 2014, Liu Renshen became dedicated to recycling, that he has successfully quit drinking alcohol. However, he still couldn't quit smoking.
When they told us to go home, I used to quickly rush downstairs smoking cigarettes, waiting for them to come.
It was until he returned to Taiwan to receive the certification as a Zhiji volunteer that he finally quit smoking successfully within 7 days.
When I feel like smoking, I used to go get a candy. Candy did help a bit. However, it was the determination and patience accompanied me to quit smoking.
Liu Renshen follows Zhiji's 10 precepts and the teaching of Master Chen Yan. Now Liu Renshen got rid of his bad habits and improved his relationship with his wife.
There is food disparity between the rich and the poor, with statistics showing that some 820 million people are on the verge of starvation. At the same time, some 2 billion people eat too much, leading to various diseases. Some 4 billion tons of food is produced every year, though nearly one-third is wasted, which could potentially feed a population of 3 billion people.
To enter this houseboat, you must first cross this wooden bridge, resting on pieces of styrofoam. It's a difficult test for this reporter.
My houseboat is very worn out and needs every time we encounter a typhoon.
You can see that the 12-square-meter houseboat is quite damp and old. The boards under the foot of the reporter have decayed. It's quite leaky, and when one enters, there's barely any room to stand up. More than 30 years ago, Mrs. Pham followed her husband from Tin Nam Tin, 100 kilometers away to capital of Hanoi. In a big city, it's hard to find work, and couples with low education get little pay. They can't afford to rent a house, as they have to live in this boat for 30 years.
Most of us don't have a fixed job. We are old and have bad health. We can only buy food every 2 or 3 days.
She stores food in a styrofoam box, which can go bad easily because there's no refrigerator. Even if you can afford to buy a refrigerator, there's no electricity here to run it. The residents of these houseboats along the coast are regarded by the Vietnamese government as illegal buildings and are not provided with water, electricity, gas, and any security. Therefore, they are mostly self-reliant, installing small solar panels on the roof to store electricity and relying on weak stored electricity at night. They also use the river water for their daily necessities.
I am cooking with firewood. Although I have a gas stove, I have no money to buy gas.
In this corner of the city, people struggle to get food and clothing. Meanwhile, in another area, people are quite affluent. Seven or eight kilometers from the houseboat is the center of Hanoi, where I am standing now. You can see that there's a lot of traffic in this area. The restaurants here are quite similar to those in Taiwan. You can find just about any type of food here.
The
Hong Kong style tea for two men would cost around $100, so there is quite a large income disparity.
The gap between rich and poor makes food distribution uneven. Research shows that children in poor environments have a significantly higher rate of malnutrition than children in wealthy families. This little girl and nine younger siblings are crammed into this big bed to sleep. There's also a table for food for her mother and grandmother.
I want to give a good meal to my grandchildren, but there is no money. This is the only thing we can give the grandchildren.
There is not enough food at home to eat. I will first let my brother and sister eat. If there is anything left, I will eat it.
This younger sister who eats leftovers suffers from long-term malnutrition and is smaller than other students. A survey found that 7.5% of global children's weight loss is due to insufficient food. Asia is most serious, where there are 9.7% of children are too thin. The number of severely malnourished people is 3.4%, which is higher than that of African children. In Vietnam, the poverty-stricken population in rural areas is four times that of the city. The number of residents under the poverty line is more than 3 million people who suffer from insufficient food and poor sanitation. Here's a slum in District 8 of Ho Chi Minh City. A local slumlord uses sheet metal to make 100 houses, which are rented to the poor. The living environment is very bad here, and from our camera we can see garbage is everywhere. One city, but two worlds.
There are a lot of people who are a family of five and only have about $5 to feed the family for two meals. And there are some rich people who spend $20 and it is still not enough for a meal.
The poor can't afford food and the rich have too much food. This phenomenon is not only found in the same country, but the gap between those in developed and underdeveloped countries is even more remarkable. In Africa, 20 people are hungry for every 100 people, while in Asian countries, although better, 11.4% of the population is still in a food shortage, while in North America and Europe, the situation is less than 2.5%. Most of the Earth's food resources are in the hands of a few economically developed countries. Research finds that people in developed countries do not cherish food, with the world's top five wasters of food being in order United States, Canada, Austria, Britain, Germany. And the world's 820 million people are starving because of insufficient food, which is equal to 1 in 10 people. But the irony is that the rich people plus the poor people in the poor countries waste 1.3 billion tons of food in the same year. There are those who eat too much and many who eat too little, as wasted food is also a problem as uneven food distribution is affecting many around the world.
Zijia USA completed training for commissioners and Faith Corps, as both groups will come to Taiwan in early November to become certified. We'll leave you with these images. Thank you and goodbye.